Assalamu alaikum to all committee judges and audience of ES 2021. Let me introduce myself and my fellow partner in this project. I am Maryam Mahmood and my project partner Zara Khan are undergraduates currently studying in Jinnah University for Women in the Department of Eastern Medicine and Surgery. We are here to present our ideas as an emerging scientist under our respected Madam Shayan Fatima. The topic that best describes our project is allocapsules for gaining the most intriguing benefits of allobarbadensis limb. The central idea of our project was to introduce aloe vera in the form of capsules, either in gel form or powder form, in the markets of Pakistan so that public can easily avail the health benefits of the plant without any hassle of extracting the gel or experiencing the bitterness of aloe gel. Upon research, we got to know that aloe vera contains vitamin B12, phenolic compounds, saponins, amino acids, anthraquinones, sterols, and salicylic acid, which gives a chirolytic effects on wounds and also produce antibiotic effects. Furthermore, it eases the effects of hangover, reduces dehydration, headaches, and dried mouth. It also relaxes nerves and prevents conversion of alcohol into harmful substances. Aloe plant is also rich in vitamin A, C, E, folic acid, and choline, which are a good source of antioxidants. It contains enzymes such as ALAs, amylase, bradykinase, which help reduce excessive inflammation. Minerals are also present such as calcium, chromium, copper, sodium, potassium, which are essential for the functioning of metabolic pathways. It contains anthraquinones, which is traditionally known as a laxative. Aloe also contains aloin and aloimodin, which act as analgesic, antibacterial, and antiviral. It has fatty acids which produce anti-inflammatory effects, and specifically fatty acid lopule possesses antiseptic effect. Hormones such as auxins and gibberellins are also present that helps in wound healing. In short, aloe vera helps in treating obesity, constipation, skin disorders, lowers blood sugar level, it detoxifies the body, reduces inflammation, and boosts immunity. So, aloe vera in the form of capsule is a convenient way of taking benefits from the wonder plant. Despite all the benefits which I discussed before, we should never ignore the contraindication of a drug. Aloe vera is contraindicated in pregnancy, breastfeeding, children under 12, hemorrhoid patient, kidney problem patient, before any type of surgery, in intestinal conditions such as ulcerative colitis, Crohn's disease, and any type of obstruction. Moving forward, we did a survey through online questionnaire form regardless of age, gender, education, and family background to know the general awareness and demand of aloe capsules in people of Pakistan. And we got a great response as 75% knew the benefits of taking aloe orally, while 80% demanded it in capsule form. Moving towards the conclusion of our poster, all above discussion that I did was solely for the purpose to introduce aloe vera in the form of capsule for easy dosing and gaining the most health benefit from the plant without the hassle of extracting the gel or experiencing the bitterness of the aloe gel. And the survey that we generated gave us a positive response and a motive to introduce aloe capsule in the markets of Pakistan and to do more research on it for better result and efficacy of the drug. That's all for our poster. Thank you for your time.